Now we are going to locate the center of mass of a uniform cone. This is a cone. Its vertex is O. R is the base radius of the cone. H is the height of the cone. Okay. Now we want to locate its center of mass. Cone is an example to continuous distribution of mass. For continuous distribution of masses, to locate center of mass, the method is method of integration, where position of center of mass xcm is equal integral xdm by integral dm. This is the formula you have to use. I shall explain clearly. Listen. Now this is the cone. Imagine that the cone is divided into number of small portions. This is a small portion. Its thickness is dx. Radius is small r. Both radii are nearly equal because thickness is very small. We have taken one such a small portion, that is at a distance x from the vertex. Okay, again I repeat, for these cases, imagine the body is divided into a number of small portions. Take one such a small portion. This is a small portion. Its thickness is dx. Its radius is r. We have taken this small portion at a distance x from the center. Okay. Now, this triangle and this big triangle are similar. For this big triangle, this length is r. For this small triangle, this length is small r. So, r by r is equal. For this big triangle, this length is h. For this small triangle, this length is small x. So, r by r is equal h by x. Am I right? So, r by r is equal x by h. R is equal x by h into r. Equation number 1. Okay, now what is the mass of the small portion? Mass of small portion. Mass of small portion. Dm is equal its area, that is pi r square, into thickness, that is dx, into density. Okay, that is the mass. Now I am going to apply this formula, and also you can take this type of small portions from here to there, that is from h is equal to 0 to, that is x is equal to 0 to x is equal to h. If you take such a small portion here, then x is equal to 0. If you take this type of small portion here, x is equal to h. So, x value lies, or x value varies between 0 and h. Right, keep it in your mind. I am going to apply this formula. XCM is equal to integral, what is dm? Pi r square dx rho into x by integral, what is dm? Pi r square dx rho. Right. X value varies between 0 and h. So, 0 to h. Here I write, XCM is equal integral 0 to h, rho is a constant that can be taken out from integration, that gets cancelled, pi also. So integral r square x dx by integral r square dx, limits are same, 0 to h. Am I right? R square x dx by r square dx is equal integral 0 to h. What is r value? See here, x by h into capital R, x by h into capital R whole square x dx by integral 0 to h. What is r square? X by h into r whole square dx. Okay, just I substituted. Here I write. Here I write. Is equal integral x square by h square r square, x square by h square r square into x dx by x square by h square into r square dx. Limits are same, 0 to h. Okay, now r square by h square is a constant that can be taken out from the integration, that gets cancelled. Here r square by h square, here also r square by h square. So what will remain? What will remain? Here I write. XCM is equal integral x cube dx by integral x square dx, 0 to h, 0 to h. What is integral x cube dx? X power 4 by 4, x power 4 by 4, limits are same, 0 to h, by what is x square dx? X cube by 3, limits are same, is equal h power 4 by 4, substitute h for x, here h cube by 3, so it will be h power 4 by 4 into 3 by h cube. Here I write, XCM is equal 3h by 4. Okay, so center of mass is situated at a distance 3h by 4. Roughly this is 3h by 4. Here center of mass is situated. Center of mass is situated at a distance 3h by 4 from the vertex on the axis of symmetry. This is the axis of symmetry. This is the position of center of mass. In this way, you can find the center of mass of a uniform cone. Okay, here the method you have to use is method of integration. XCM is equal to integral xdm by integral dm. Right.